Boatsinker. Gör din röst hörd, Boatsinker.
Kalla den änglamarken no. eller himmeljorden om du vill.
Hörru, do you hear it?
Tack. Ni svenska vaktton.
Här.
Med plutonium. Tvingar vi dansken på knä.
That's beautiful.
Här. Danmark. Utskitet av kalk och vatten. Och där. Sverige. Hugget i granit. Dansk. Jävlar. Dansk! Jävlar!
Hej, vi...
Hej!
Vi får väl ta det här på engelska eftersom Lord Lolland har en sån fruktansvärd dialekt.
Det fick hända har hänt.
Yeah.
Jag har gjort jättemånga kineser ledsna.
Vad är det här? Börjar den gå igen?
Do we have Boatsy? Is he here?
I think so. He is Boatsy. Unmuted. Can you tell him to please unmute himself?
How? I mean, should I write him in like on signal?
So, anyways, it's a very sad
text him
situation that two neighboring peoples with similar languages has to communicate in English in this
globalized world.
It is horrible, and but I mean,
it's just Lord Lolland.
We're supposed to learn some. Norwegian
du försvinner, Kristoffer.
Hallå.
Hello.
Yeah. It's are you here now? Boatsinker?
Yeah, it's working. Yeah.
Can I make a proper introduction? Okay.
So oh, yeah, of course.
We have the Danes, Boatsinker, and Lord Lolland from Radio 266B. It's our Central Europeans LARPing as Scandis brothers from another mother.
Thanks for the drop, by the way.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. So we could call you podcast colleagues. We actually syndicated your podcast in the beginning until everyone complained about Lord Lolland's dialect. So we had
it's awful. Even in Danish, it's terrible.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
My dialect is fine.
I'm totally cool speaking with Danes in our native tongues, but it's just this one exception. That's you, Lord Lolland.
It's a linguistic show listening to that guy. I mean, it just doesn't work in any capacity.
Yeah, I like that my plan worked to pile on Lord Lolland.
it's a staple of our podcast as well to pile on me. Because Klaus and our other regular. What do you call it? Co-host.
BFF.
Kreutzmann, he's... they're both from Jutland, and I'm from, Lolland. And they mock me endlessly, calling me an alcoholic, calling me unemployed. All true, of course, but still.
You're not supposed to say that. Well, it's good. Me and Daniel have a similar relationship. I call him an alcoholic, he calls me unemployed, so... which both are sort of true and not, but anyways, so guys,
once again the Danish are more efficient than the Swedes because we have centralized both alcoholism and unemployment in one person.
Yeah, well, that's the other thing. I'm happy you see it as a major accomplishment, Lolland. you also have a website. I should just mention that, so as to seem to make you seem more of a serious entity. You started Dagens Blase. Dagens Blase?
Exactly. Thank you. This is gold, by the way.
Yeah. This is, you will have to, we can arrange some sort of shekels afterwards for my plugging of your website. But anyways.
Yeah, I will put the 2 500 notes in your hand next time I see you. For sure.
Are we talking Danish? If so, I can just retire. Fuck you. Fuck you. I quit. I'm out of here.
The DKK shekels will rain heavy.
I mean, have you seen what's happened to the Swedish krona? Have you seen?
No, it's not a shower.
I
haven't followed it recently, but I'm guessing it's weak as always.
Basically, I'm not going abroad for the next 10 years.
Yeah, you should probably never go abroad for various reasons. But the Swedish crown being weaker and weaker with every year is one of those reasons. I mean, it's the Swedish economy is collapsing. Who would have thought that multiculturalism would actually cost money and ruin our economy?
Are you sure it's not just evil, straight, white Swedish people who are gobbling up all the money and leaving nothing for the poor immigrants?
Yeah, maybe. Also a possibility.
I mean, I hope so. But honestly, they both have to like just burn or something. I don't
the
like
last it. Time I hired a car in Göteborg, it was very cheap, but the next time it'll be pretty much a free ride.
Oh yeah, it's cheaper than Uber, no doubt. So anyways, you only have 20 minutes left, by the way, so let's start to get into
the
series.
Can I do a quick plug?
I already plugged you. No,
this is the announcement. I'm just launching my own Boatsinker site, boatsinker.online. So
what?
I did it anyway. Sure. Sorry, Daniel.
Why? what's
because my archive, my online archive at Tumblr got short. So
oh right.
So yeah, now I got my own site.
Yeah,
12-year-old girl.
Yeah, Tumblr doesn't seem to.
Can I plug my Tumblr real quick?
No, you can.
Well, Boatsinker is also maybe most famous, at least internationally, for your art. Your what do you call them? Your comics? Your sketches?
Drawings.
You're the guy who runs the My Nationalist Pony Tumblr site, right?
Oh my god! Here we go again. So, anyways, there's stuff happening in Denmark. That's why I invited you to.
Yeah.
So
we're having of course the EU election this Sunday and the 5th of June, which is also our Constitution Day, one of our two sort of national days. We are having a national election.
Right.
With the if people have been watching nationalist outlets, they might have seen a big sort of fat guy, usually in a silly hat because his hair's even sillier, who goes around and burns Korans and calls people exactly the same things that they call him. And he got at the last minute he got eligible for running his party Stram Kurs, which he translates to hard line, but it's more like a tight course, and it sounds as sexual in Danish as it does in English. And he got that eligible to run for parliament, and I think they're polling at about between 2 and 4%, and 2% is the cutoff. Below 2%, they don't get into parliament unless they get a personal mandate with like what is it, about 20,000. Yeah, vote for one guy. But if they get 2% or more, they get proportionally represented in parliament.
That's good. Should we say his name too?
Rasmus Paludan.
Rasmus Paludan. I thought it was Rasmus Paludan, but it's Paludan. That's
Paludan.
A strange name, by the way. Is that is that a normal name in Danish? Or
it's rare, but it's an old family name that goes back to the 1600s.
Yeah, some what was it? Some Latin teacher who Latinized a normal Danish name. It's Kær, I think it was. So Paludan is supposed to mean fra Kær, from the what's that in English? Pond, from the pond,
from the pond, from the lake.
Yeah, he's Our Lady of the Lake, or something. And it's been a wild ride. It's been a wild ride, this election, with him calling like old minister, retired ministers for Nazis, and calling the a Jewish editor of a major newspaper a Nazi. And of course, they called him Nazi first, so that's why he calls them Nazis.
I'm kind of surprised that works, because that wouldn't really work in Sweden, because everybody would just like shrug emoji. But in Denmark, it seems that he is being outrageous in the same way that they think that the Sweden Democrats or the Alternative for Sweden is outrageous, because the Danish People's Party is essentially cucks. So he's kind of like something new and exciting and shocking in Danish politics.
Well, it didn't seem like it would work, because he had been in like 50 ghettos where he was like, you know, irritating the foreigners, basically just showing up, being his usual self, and, you know, creating havoc. And it didn't work. He got like 2,000 out of 20,000 signatures. So it seemed very unlikely that he would stand for elections. But then there was a riot in Copenhagen after they attacked him physically. And right after that, it just exploded. And within like a few days, he had all the signatures. It was a complete surprise to everyone. But
yeah, it was, because I met him at the Skansa Forum in what was that? When was that?
Early September.
No, not that.
The latest one.
Yeah, not the one where he accused me of not being pro-Israel enough. That's not the Skansa. The other one in Sweden. When was it? Was it in March or something?
Yeah.
February. Whatever. Earlier this year, and I talked to him, and he's very good at speaking Swedish, by the way. You should take some lessons, Lolland. Maybe one day we can meet as equals. But anyways,
nice of you to dox him, by the way. I'm ruining his chances in the elections.
Oh, no. He's far beyond that. He's burning Korans in ghettos. So I don't think
that will happen. He was a guy who actually brought up the great replacement in this debate on
TV.
Yes,
exactly.
Yeah, that was very good. I mean, that actually made international headlines. I mean, it was all over Europe. And just by doing that, he won a major metapolitical victory for our cause.
His redemption arc is, it's quite interesting. But I talked to him then, and he was very unsure of getting all these signatures. And then, as you said, he just exploded onto the political scene. And then I don't know why they decided to give him all the attention. Was it because of the riots, or
it was
else?
The riots.
Yeah. They lasted like 24 hours. The riots. Okay. So they burned like half the city down, basically.
And police began finding like hand grenades. So I suspect some Swedes were involved, or new Swedes. So it was a lot of news coverage, simply because they couldn't ignore that the police were finding hand grenades and migrants were basically trying to raise a part of the capital. They couldn't ignore that.
Yeah, and they also blew up a car the day before where he was supposed to give another speech in a ghetto.
Oh yeah, that too.
Yeah.
So this thing, will it take him all the way? Do you think so? I mean, 2-4%, he's already there.
Definitely.
So he is. I will say he is going to get into parliament. At least him, most likely his party. I'm guessing maybe 5% at most. I mean, the polls are usually, especially the ones that's only giving him 2%. It's from an agency. What is it? Voxmeter, I believe. That notoriously gets nationalist parties, or even, well, nationalist party, you know, Danish People's Party, even though they're cocked as all hell, they underestimate them consistently, and they are the ones giving him, oh, he might just enter parliament, but the other agencies are giving him 3-4%, and I think they are underestimating him, because he's such an unknown entity in electoral politics. So I think he's going to get him and his party is going to get about those 5%, and they are going to wreck the entire system. Yeah. I am looking forward.
What
I am looking so
hell.
Much forward to what's his name, Helmut Nyborg.
He's on the list.
He's one of the candidates. He's
no
the
really. I totally
yeah,
missed
in,
it.
Eastern yeah. Jutland.
He's actually a very respected scientist worldwide in his field. But he also spoke at the Skansa Forum in Copenhagen, and I really like him. He's a great man, really is.
Yeah.
So that's
he's
good
one
news.
Of the guys who's probably going to get in on the party ticket, and I am looking forward to the day where he will stand on the speaker's podium in Folketinget and talk about how people from the south have lower IQs. That would be wonderful.
This is such a revenge for him, because he was ostracized in Denmark after a false scandal where he was involved in some network with people who are interested about IQ differences, intelligence in populations, etc. So that will be really a huge comeback for him. Interesting. So
yeah, a lot of the candidates are excellent. I mean, they're very diverse. There's like the Paludan types and some more serious types. So I'm really looking forward to seeing who gets represented in parliament. But he's definitely going in. But I was very optimistic about the alternative for Sweden in the election September. Yeah. But that was a huge letdown. But this time around, I'm pretty sure that it'll be successful.
Yeah, it's I'm almost irritated that Alternative for Sweden is trying to be serious, also appropriating some of the meme culture and really do a hard work, and these are great guys, etc. And they have a serious platform. They have a great website. They have good PR tactics, etc. And then this fat guy from Denmark, like to burn Korans, he probably throws bacon at Muslims. And
he cooked it on the burning Korans.
He cooked what?
Bacon.
I didn't even know that. I was just guessing. So he comes in.
But of course he does.
Yeah, but of course the Dane, the not so serious, outrageous Danes, come here into this like respectable political discussion like a wrecking ball and just.
Czech Koran burner versus virgin serious politician.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's the virgin, serious virgin versus the Chad wrecking ball, Dane, whatever. So I guess because I talked to you a little bit about him before, and I got the impression that you weren't a big fan of him and his tactics, but you like the outcome of it. Or has he changed? He's a meme candidate now.
Yeah. We obviously support him because the net positives are obvious. So it's like the Trump train, but in a more serious manner, because we can get some actual results from this more than we could with Trump.
Right. But he's not a clown though, because he is actually a lawyer, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he is a bit of a clown still.
Yeah, he is.
So that is mutually exclusive, Chris?
Yeah, but coming from a background in law, you know, we take ourselves very seriously, et cetera, et cetera. But sure. But what I meant was that he is a clown. He may be a clown, but he's not stupid. He's intelligent.
Yeah.
He knows what he's doing.
Yeah, and he's gonna use this to its fullest potential. He's not gonna go into parliament and just take it easy. He's gonna, be a tornado.
Yeah.
I was very skeptical about Paludan and his party back when they first arrived, because it looked like they were trying to fill the void from Danskernes Parti when that closed, and to fill it with and a more kosher alternative. But now that they, on their website, they call themselves ethno-nationalist utilitarians, and just that there are more to their party than just counter jihadism. I've become really, really optimistic, and I am so looking forward to this election.
So once he's in for how many years? Four.
No, they can make a new election at any time. Call an election.
And right. Because of the parliamentary situation, they're probably going to make a new election before the end of the summer.
You have an election on the 5th.
We have a maximum of 4 years between elections, but the prime minister can call an election at any time.
Technically, the queen, but yeah, the prime minister calls the election. And if there cannot be found a new prime minister after the election, which it looks like there can't, because the wings of the two the right and left blocks, they won't really collaborate with this with the more centrist parties, you know, the Social Democrats and the market liberals,
the Sargons of this world.
Yeah, basically they liberals. Won't collaborate with them unless they get their ultimate goals, like I think the lefties, some of the extreme lefties want more climate stuff, and some of the extreme, but the
extremists,
the libertarians want tax cuts, and they won't collaborate with the leaders of their respective blocs if they don't get that. So if there can't be found a centrist government, which is very unlikely, then it'll probably be an election again. And well, we can technically have elections as little as a month apart.
There's no limits.
Usually,
there's no limits.
Yeah, usually the government lasts like 3 years, 3.5 years. It's okay. Not like in Italy where they have like in a summer election each year.
No, yeah. So okay, so he's coming in. He's entering the parliament. He is probably bringing a few people with him, and then there's going to be a new election in at the end of the summer, and probably. Probably has to do some more burnings, right? He has the whole summer to
sure
build up.
But I mean, maybe it's his barbecue season. So
yeah, literally it is. So he's gonna if I want to have a good barbecue, I'll just try to go to Denmark sometime this summer.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. And I guess
even if it wasn't a political barbecue, just we have a lot of cheap pork meat, so it is the best place to have a barbecue.
Yeah, but it's also full of antibiotics, so I'll probably
that makes it healthy.
It's the Danish kind, the best kind.
Yes.
So, anyways, okay. What about you guys? What's going on? What's the plan for? I mean, I guess you're having tons of fun with the Paludan, or whatever you say. But what's the strategy for you? What's your goals? Are you doing something more than just podcasting, shit posting, etc.?
Well, we're trying to write. I do most of the writing of the articles, but it's like between 5 and 7 articles per week. So we're making a continuous effort to keep that going, and you know, because there's a huge void in Denmark. The nationalist. The number of nationalists is not like in Sweden, where it's you can basically have a ton of organizations and a lot of paying members, and you know, get something off the ground. We don't have that critical mass in Denmark. So anything you do as a nationalist in Denmark basically fills a void. So we're trying to fill the void of having a podcast, which we are still the only ones doing it.
Yeah.
And then having a news site with you know, articles from a nationalist point of view.
So and that's great. I mean, you're doing enough as it is. But I think one thing that I experienced with Alternative for Sweden was that they took the people who are usually sitting reading articles, listening to podcasts. They took them out to the streets. They took them out to town meetings. They formed organizations to help with all the logistical issues. And now they have become friends, and they have sort of built this Männerbund. I was actually visiting one of them as recently as this week, and there were about 15 people there. They had their own office space, or whatever you call it. And so this is happening, and I think that if you're riding the coattails of Stram Kurs, then probably. I know that's gonna be a drop.
That's but
whatever,
excellent.
Whatever. So I think that you have a big, huge chance to get in touch and maybe form small communities around this very eccentric but interesting person.
Yeah. Well, we have some people, you know, some connections in this thing that he's gotten off the ground. So yeah, what we can build from that, I don't know, but. Yeah, we're definitely exploiting it in some regards.
As you should. And now I'm jealous for the first time in my life. I'm jealous of Danes.
Wow.
Like, imagine a plot twist.
Yeah, but as far as organizing something, my dream is to do what Dan Eriksson has done.
Yeah.
I really like that project.
Are you by any chance, are you coming to the event on Saturday? No.
Possibly, no, I'm not. I'm not coming to this, but I want to visit the house sometime this year. I don't know if it'll be the summer party in August or when.
All right, yeah. The 10th of August. He dropped the news here, actually. Yeah. So
that's I definitely want to show up. I had a plan to go visit with a buddy of mine, but it was a weekday. There wasn't any event there, and it was just to drop by and say hi. And I thought 700 kilometers to say, oh, hi, Dan, can I have a cup of coffee? Yeah, sure. And then go home again. That was, wasn't worth it.
It's not worth it. So, okay. Well, anything else you want to plug before your time is up?
Very soon, the up-to-date boatsinger.online will be up. And of course, Dan's Blazer, but I don't think a lot of Swedes will be visiting that anyway, but they can if they want to.
That's very, very generous of you.
Yeah, thanks for letting us visit your website.
Well, you know me.
For free. You have to read a superior language, but apart from that, I think you can manage.
Yeah.
Well, guys, it's been...
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. It was to be in this company. I mean, it's been an all-star lineup. And then Lolland showed up.
Yeah. I mean, we had a good run. I knew that was going to happen, but, you know, I value the struggle more than my own personal ego. I'm not a perfectionist, so I
managed to be sober for this, and you guys just shitting all over me. I am very offended.
Wait. Oh, that's why you were so boring. What the hell? I told Boatsinker.
I figured among Swedes you have to either be sober or so absolutely drunk that you can't speak, and it's really a bad idea that implying, to go on a podcast if you can't speak.
Implying you can speak whilst sober, but I digress.
There is a middle way, actually.
No, there's apparently for Danes it's all or nothing. Either you have the Danish People's Party, which is a massive cock party, or you have a Paludan, which you may have barbecues with Qurans and eat like bacon every day. So no, it's nice to see. It's nice to see that things are happening. I know you've been struggling, Boatsinker.
Now I'll be voting for the first time in I don't know how many years, because I usually don't vote in the national elections. It's no one to vote for.
Yeah.
But I will this time.
That's good, guys. I am going to forcefully remove you now. I'm going to physically...
Shut it down.
I'm going to shut you down. No, I can't shut you down, actually. So I just have to politely ask you to leave.
Okay. Take care.
Okay.
Take care, guys.
Take care. Bye.